Thank you. Govinda, he was அது பிறகு ராதாராணி பகவான் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணர் சொல்றார், நான் எல்லா நதியும் இங்கு வர வைத்து இங்கே நான் பிடிக்க போகிறேன் சொன்னார்.
And saying this, Lord Krishna stuck a seal in the ground and then called all the holy rivers. And they all came one after another, and all the deities of each of the holy rivers all came. Right? Ganga, Yamuna, Gurubari, Narmada, Saraswati, Kaveri, they all came one after another, all the different deities came and they brought water and they poured it on
Krishna. சரஸ்வதி, கோதாவரி, நிர்மலா எல்லா நதிகளும் அந்த இடத்துல ஒன்று கூடி அவங்களுடைய
தீர்த்தார்கள்.
பகவான் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணன் சாம குண்டத்தை
உருவாக்கினார். You have to purify yourself because you've been associating with me.
அதுபிறகு ஸ்ரீமதி ராதாரணி கண்டு சொன்னார், நீங்களும் அதை ஸ்ரீமதி ராதாரணி அதை குறித்து நீராட வேண்டும், என நீங்களும் கலந்துபட்டிருந்தீங்க.
So Radharani and all the gopis, they got together and they started to bring water from the Manasakanda. All the gopis, they were carrying buckets of water, pots of water from Manasakanda, pouring it
there.
But then Lord Krishna didn't like to see the gopis working so hard. He told them, it's okay, I will create the kund. And Lord Krishna created the Radha
kund.
So these two kunds, Radha kund and Shama kund, they're situated just at the side of the Govardhan hill.
The Radha kundum, Shama kundum, Govardhan area,
so they're very special places because it was there that Radha and Krishna, they could enjoy their intimate pastimes. Radharani enjoys more intimacy in Radha Kund because not so many people there. When they have Rasa Leela, there's so many gopis.
So
the Radha Kund is a very, very sacred, very special place. And Giri Govardhan, of course, the hill of Giri Raj, the king of mountains, is also very, very sacred. When people go to Vrindavan, they will go to Govardhan and they will circumambulate the Govardhan hill. They go around the hill. It's 22 kilometers to go around. But the hill of Govardhan is described in the words of the gopis in the Srimad Bhagavatam. They say, Haridasa Bharya, that this hill is the best of all the devotees of Lord Hari.
Haridasa Bharya.
And Srimad Bhagavatam, Maharaj Yudhisthira is called Haridas, and Prahlad is also called Haridas. But the Govardhan Hill is Haridas Avarya, the very best of all the devotees of Lord Hari. So then they say Kalindi means the river Kalindi, which is a branch of the Ganga. It's another name for the Yamuna.
Kalindi is the Yamuna matter pair, although the Gangi Langitwa are put in one branch, Yamuna is not.
So Yamuna Kalindi was one of the gopis who got married to Krishna when Krishna was well, Krishna wanted to get some wives, right? He wanted to get married. After he'd taken Rukmini for a wife, somehow he came there to the area of Mathura, and he was with Arjuna one day, and they were walking along the banks of the Yamuna, and they saw this young lady. They saw this young lady who was very young lady, very beautiful, and they were surprised to see a young lady there on her own. So she said, Krishna told Arjuna, go and ask this young woman, who is she? What's she doing here? So Arjuna, and she told Arjuna, she said, I am the daughter of the son of the god, Lord Vishnu is my husband. So my father made a house for me here in the water of the Yamuna. And I'm staying here, I'm waiting for Lord Vishnu to take me as his wife. So in this way, Lord Krishna accepted her. Arjuna brought the girl to Lord Krishna, and she surrendered to Lord Krishna, and Lord Krishna asked him to go up there. It's one of his wives. And then the song says Jaya Mahavan. Mahavan is one of the forests of Vrindavan. There are 12 forests in Vrindavan. They're situated around the Yamuna. The river Yamuna flows through all these 12 forests. And then Kesigata. Kesigata is where Lord Krishna killed the Kesi demon.
Right.
Who's the Kesi demon? Do you know?
Who's the Kesi? You know
Kesi?
Who's Kesi?
You don't know?
I don't know.
Oh my goodness.
Devananda
know? Kesi demon? By Krishna.
Who is Kesi?
Snake.
You're not hearing Krishna book?
Oh, never did see Krishna book. Say demon.
You don't know the demons Krishna killed?
You know? Yes. How the demon
look?
Kesi demon? Kill. Who's killing Kesi?
He killed some Krishna.
Krishna did.
Krishna killed them.
Kesi,
then? Okay.
Kesi came in the form of a horse.
Ah, I agree.
Very proud.
Kesi.
Very proud horse.
Kesi ingra vandu kudrai vadivathula vandu romba avishyamaga seyapattara irundha vandu.
And he came running towards Krishna. Krishna stuck his hand in his mouth.
Choked him.
So Kesi demon was killed by Krishna. Of course, the demons who get killed by Krishna, they get liberated. So that's a one place there on the bank of the Yamuna. It's called Kesigat.
And the Yamuna Nadi Garu, one place, கேசி காட்டுச்சு.
The place where Krishna killed the Kesi demon.
There is a lot of Kesi in the Asurani Bhagavan.
And then there is a Vamsi Vata tree.
Vamsi Vata is a maram irukkirathu.
Vamsi Vata, it's a tree where Krishna would play the flute and he'd call all the gopis.
There is a Bhagavan Prabhuji and a gopi ralipar. Vamsi Vata is a tree.
So Lord Krishna performed these pastimes in all these different places of
Vrindavan.
And then this song says also glories to all the cowherd boys who were with Krishna. And the head of the cowherd boys was Sri Dham. He is the older brother of Radharani. And also he's the older brother of Ananga Manjari. So they all come in Krishna's pastime. And then we hear about Vrishabhanu. Vrishabhanu is the father of Radharani. And what's the name of the mother? Chukida. Yes. And then Purnamasi. Purnamasi is the mother of Sandipani Muni.
Purnamasi is Sandipani Muni.
Who's Sandipani Muni? Who's Sandipani Muni?
Krishna goes to school with Balaram.
They went to the school of Sandipani Muni.
Bhagavan Sri Krishna and Balaram are Sandipani Muni.
And then the song says, all glories to Gopeshwara Shiva, the Lord of the Gopis. Lord Shiva took the form, he wanted to go to Rasa Lila. So like they told him, look, you have to take the form of a gopi.
அதனால ராசிகளை போன்றா நீங்க வந்து ஒரு பெண் உருவத்தை சொல்லி அவருக்கு
So he took bath in the lake and he came out in the form of a gopi.
அதனால அவர் படுக்கையை குளிச்சு வரும்போது அவர் பெண் உருவத்தை எடுத்து வந்தார்
But then Krishna came and said, just a minute, who are you? What gopi are you? I don't know you.
அதாவது கிருஷ்ண பார்க்கிறார் சந்தேகமா இருக்கு யாரு எந்த கோபி பார்த்ததே இல்லையா
அப்படின்னு கிருஷ்ண தோஷி அதனால
கிருஷ்ண சொன்ன நீங்க கண்டிப்பாக இந்த ராசிக்கு வர முடியாது
But he told him, you can be the lord of the gopi.
அதனால நீங்க வந்து கோபியர்களுக்கு
you can be Gopeshwara Shiva.
நீங்க கோபீஸ்வர சிவனாக
இருக்கணும் So they have a special Shiva Linga in Vrindavan, they dress him as a gopi.
அதனால இந்த கோபீஸ்வரர் மாதேவர் வந்து இந்த வந்தாமல் கோபியை கூட அவங்களுக்கு ஆதாரமாக
This is Gopeshwara Shiva.
அதுதான் கோபீஸ்வர சிவன்
But usually Shiva resides in the holy dham. He is Kshetrapal Shiva.
முக்கியமாக சிவம் வந்து வந்தாமல் கஷேத்திரப்பாளராக இருக்கார்
Means he protects the holy dham.
அப்படின்னா இந்த அந்த புனித நடத்தை காவலாக இருக்கிறார்
And to enter the holy dham, you have to get his permission. Before you can go in the parikrama, you have to come and beg permission from Lord Shiva. Because Lord Shiva is in charge for the holy dham.
அதுவும் சிவபெருமாள் தான் அந்த இடத்துல அந்த பிருந்தாவனத்தை பார்த்தது
And then the song says, All glories to Ramagata, where Lord Balaram dances Rasalila.
பிறகு இந்த இடத்துல ராமகாத்த பற்றி சொல்லப்படுகிறது அங்கதான் பலராம வந்து அங்க இல்லப்பட்டாரு
So Lord Rama also dances Rasalila, not only Krishna.
அல்ல பலராம் கூட அங்க
ரோஹிணி
இன்னொரு பேர் பலராமருக்கு ரோஹிணி நந்தன் ஏன்னா ரோஹிணி மாதாவுடைய புதல்வனாக இருக்கு
Originally Lord Balaram appeared in the womb of Devaki.
முதலாவது பலராம தேவியுடைய கருவிலிருந்து உருவாகி
But after about 7 or 8 months pregnancy, he was transferred from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohini.
பிறகு 7 மாசத்துல இந்த பலராம் கருவில இருக்கும்போது அது அப்படியே ரோஹிணி மாதாவுக்கு மாற்றப்பட்டது
And Rohini is one of the wives of Vasudev, just like Devaki. Vasudev had several wives. So Vasudev and Devaki, they were in the prison house of Kamsa. So Lord Balaram appeared first in the womb of Devaki, But then by Yoga Maya, by the arrangement of Yoga Maya, he was transferred into the womb of Rohini.
பலராமர் முதல் தேவியை கர்ப்பத்திலேயே பிறகு யோக மாய சக்தியாக அது ரோஹிணி அவர் கர்ப்பத்துக்கு மாற்றப்பட்டார்
Rohini was staying in the home of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda in Gokul.
அந்த நேரத்தில் ரோஹிணி யசோதா மாய கூட நந்த மகாராஜும் பிருந்தாவனத்தில் தனியாக இருந்தாங்க
So, She was safe there. Kamsa could not give her any trouble. So Lord Balaram was transferred there. He took birth there in Gokul. So then we hear about the Dvijapatnis, the wives of the Brahmanas. The Dvijapatnis, the Brahmanas. The Dvijas, the Brahmanas, were doing a yagya one morning and Krishna and the cowherd boys, they were hungry and they saw the Brahmanas had a lot of food So they thought, we'll go and ask the Brahmanas if we can get some of their food.
The Goja Patnigal Sura, the Brahman or the Patnigal, Madigal, and the Brahman Ram, Sada Yagamal, Ruba Yupatil Pagal, the Rodi Yagam Nakuru, Mose, Krishna Bakum, Mose, and the Brahman Rangi, and the Prashadam of Angel Sugan Picture.
So the cowherd boys went and they asked the Brahmanas, my dear Brahmanas, Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram are here, we didn't get any breakfast this morning. Could we get some food? And the Brahmanas just ignored them. They just pretended they didn't hear anything. So the cowherd boys came back and they told Lord Krishna what happened. And Lord Krishna said, don't worry, that's begging is like that. When you go begging, you have to expect sometimes you're not going to be
successful.
So then he said, go and ask the wives of the Brahmins. Go and see the Dvijapatnis. So he went to see the wives. And when the ladies heard, the Krishna and Balaram are there and said, wow, whoa, quick! And they all picked up all the food they prepared for the yaga and they came running to Krishna and Balaram to bring food for them.
Krishna and Balaram and the Krishna and Balaram
so they were all great devotees. But their husbands were not there. And then they offered prayer to Nagakanya God. Nagakanya means the wives of the Kaliya serpent, the snake who came and poisoned the Yamuna. All the water of the Yamuna was poisoned because Kaliya had come to live there. So the cows, they couldn't drink the water without, they'd be killed because the water was not poisonous. So when Krishna heard, Krishna came there and he jumped into the water of the Yamuna. And there was this big snake, Kaliya, with many hoods, poisonous snake living in the water. And he came and immediately he caught Krishna in his coils and he held him in his coils for a long time. And Mother Yashoda, all the people of Vrindavan, they were fainting. Oh no, Krishna is going to be killed by this snake. Oh, they were so worried, they were all dying. But then Krishna got free and he danced on all the hoods of the snake. And he was going to, he could have killed the snake, but all the wives of the snake, they came and they prayed to Lord Krishna. And they prayed to Krishna, please don't kill our husband. We don't want to be widows. So Lord Krishna told Kaliya, he said, then get out of here. Do not come here in the Yamuna. You go and stay in the ocean far away from here. And Lord Krishna said, I know you only came here to save yourself because you know you Garuda couldn't come here. But he said, Garuda will not trouble you now because I put my footprints on your head. So Garuda will see my footprints on your head. He won't touch you.
கால் பாதம் வந்து உங்களுடைய தலையில இருக்கிறது, அதனால நீ கருணால பாதுகாப்பு இருக்கும் என்று
சொல்றேன்.
பகவான் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணன் ராசலீலைக்கு நாயகத்தை பற்றி வர்ணிக்கப்படுகிறது.
One is Parakya and one is Swakya. Swakya means with marriage, and Parakya means without marriage. So Lord Krishna's pastimes in Vrindavan with the gopis are Parakya rasa, without marriage.
திருமணம் ஆகாதவர்களுக்கு அவங்களுடைய உறவும், பிறகு பாக்கிய என்பது திருமணம் ஆனவர்கள். அதில் பகவான் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணன் பிருந்தாவனத்தில் அவர் யாரும் அந்த திருமணம் பண்ணல, அதனால் அந்த தூய்மையான அந்த உறவை பற்றி வர்ணிக்கக்கூடிய இடங்கள்லாம் பிருந்தாவனத்தை சொல்லி இங்கே
வர்ணிக்கிறார்.
பிறகு கடைசியில் இங்கே ஜனவ தேவி பற்றி வருகிறாங்க. ஜனவ வந்து நித்யானந்த பிரபுடைய அவருடைய
பத்னி.
நித்யானந்த பிரபு அவர்கள் ரெண்டு மனைவி வசுதா என் ஜனவா ஆகக்கூடிய ரெண்டு பேர்.
So, this is the song of holy places.
Any question about the Vrindavan Dham?
Who's been to Vrindavan?
Yaro Vrindavan Boyka?
Yes, Goloka, Moku, there is a the Rakshakas, right? Vrindavan is Goku, and this planet is like the embassy of the spiritual world, right? Not different. Lord Krishna was shook that the people of Vrindavan, they approached Krishna one time, they wanted to see the spiritual world. So Krishna revealed the spiritual world to them and they said, ah, it just looks like our place. They were surprised to see it was just the same as Vrindavan. And he said, yeah, this is the supreme world and the spiritual world. Not different.
this is a spiritual doubt, because you don't see any difference.
Well, the material place, there's a covering over it that you have to have. You have to have love to enter into the holy Dhamma. You don't see the holy Dhamma unless your eyes are purified. You go to the holy place, you won't see the holy place. You just see with material vision. You have to understand the holy Dhamma with spiritual vision. Krishna cannot be understood by the material sense. Atashi Krishna Nabadi Nabhavat Priyamandriyani Seva Mukhihi Jivado Swayam Evas Puratiyada. Krishna cannot be understood by the material senses, so neither can the Holy Dhamma, because the Holy Dhamma is not different from Krishna. So you cannot understand Krishna, you cannot understand the Holy Name, you cannot understand the holy Dhamma by material senses. We have to purify ourselves. Then we can see the holy Dhamma.
In Bhakti Leela, they say you must stay in the holy Dhamma. That means we have to go and stay in holy Dhamma. That means we can understand we can purify. Just by saying we staying in holy Dhamma.
Just by staying in the holy Dhamma? Yes, staying in the holy Dhamma, but you have to stay in the mood of a devotee. You have to engage in devotional service. You have to hear and chant. You have to do service. Go and see the deities. You have to go play dramas. You have to do also all the tapasya. Otherwise you won't, you don't just go, if you go to the holy Dhamma and just go shopping every day, sometimes people go to holy Dhamma, they just go for shopping. So that is not the real way to enter the holy Dhamma. You can say, well, that's also service, yeah, it is. But you want to see the holy place, you have to understand there's qualification. Enter into the holy place. You don't enter the holy place just by buying a ticket to go there. You have to change the conscience.
Jai Krishna. Jai.
Jai.